Hi everyone. This video is part one of your Gothic Cathedral project. And so as you can see, I have my Gothic Cathedral drawn out. There's a lot of detail. And one of the interesting things is a Gothic Cathedral often has three sections, one, two, three, and three levels, bottom floor, middle floor, and top floor. And that represents something very important in the religion. If you were Roman Catholic, you might understand what the three stand for. You are going to be doing a lot of detail work. You'll be making a stained glass window out of paper and watercolor and gluing it on. This probably looks harder than it is because I'm going to start out with some templates today. And I have just three. I'm making myself a square. Yeah, almost a square. If you draw this out with a ruler on a piece of paper, then you have something that you can trace around. I'm going to have a doorway. And I think I might need a template for a tower, which will just be a triangle. Off a little bit. And that's what I can start with. I just those three shapes to build my Gothic cathedral. So using a pencil and a ruler, I'm just going to center this and go ahead and trace. And this will be where my main doorway is to my Gothic cathedral. Gothic cathedrals were usually made out of stone, but the trim was made out of wood. And so I'll put this right here. I will bring this down a little bit. And when you use your templates, feel free to slide them up or down to give you a little bit more use. And let's see, I want that letter U shaped door, one over here, and one over here. So this is the bottom of my cathedral, and I think I'll keep going. So next, this section of my cathedral will be where I'll place my stained glass window. So maybe I'll put that down a little bit. And just trace around this. The middle section, and I'll use this shape again, but this time maybe I won't use the letter U. I might want to do my windows a little differently than I did the door. Put one here, and I'll put one over here. Came down a little bit. I came down a little bit because I wanted to be sure I was going to have enough room for my towers. And I think I'll do two towers and then maybe a high steeple in the middle. Let's see, use my ruler. Just gonna give myself a line across here. Place this one right here. That looks pretty nice. And I'll put one over here. Start to line it up. And then I'll find the center. And do I want to curve this? Yeah, I think I'll make this a little bit of a curve. The pointed arch was one of the main features of Gothic architecture. So I can curve that in a little bit. So next, I think I will go ahead and design a big front door. And go here. I like to make dots first because it helps me keep things straight. I'm just going to sketch this down. Sketch this down. Across. And here, of course, I'll be having my stained glass window. But this, I think I'll divide in half so that I can do sort of a double level of windows. Because I know the more detail I add to this drawing, the better it will look. And I'll have a small window here. I'm going to want to use the idea of the stained glass window as much as I can because it gives me a chance to add some color. We know that the window would have to have a window frame. I'll just come in and do this. Maybe I'll come across like that. Looks nice. I'll come up like this. And so I could do another set of windows down here. And I won't do both sides because I don't want this video to get too long. But just think of all the different details that you can put in your drawing. You can do not just the stained glass windows, you can make it look like it's the rooftop is made out of tiles or shingles. You can do a very fancy doorway with lots of levels, maybe a little doorway over it. Give yourself plenty of places where you'll be able to add color to your drawing. So I'm going to stop now, and this is how you will get set up for your stained glass window project with a basic drawing. And enjoy doing this. Take your time, and adding detail will be important. So enjoy.